Now, unexpected revelations more than 60 years after one of the more seminal moments in the civil rights era. That is the focus of Timothy Tyson's new book, The Blood of Emmett Till, the latest addition to the NewsHour bookshelf. Jeffrey Brown spoke with him recently.
Why retell this story? What drove you to want to take another look?
I was actually working on another book, and a nice woman from Raleigh called me on the phone and wanted to tell me how much she liked my previous book. She said, well, my mother-in-law's coming next week. I gave her the book for Christmas, and she liked it very much, and we'd like to have a cup of coffee with you. She said, well, you might know my mother-in-law. Her name was Carolyn Bryant. And, of course, being a historian of the 20th century, the civil rights movement, I knew that Carolyn Bryant had not uttered a word in public about the lynching of Emmett Till since 1955.
The woman at the store, yes, who made the claims about Emmett Till.
In whose name he was lynched.
Remind us what she had said and what she says now.
In court, she testified to something that was tantamount to sexual assault, to coming around the counter, grabbing her by the waist with his hands and not letting go and speaking to her sexually.
And you've broken some new ground here with having her say that the most sensational parts of her testimony were not true.
Yeah. In reference to the physical piece, she said, that part's not true. Nothing that boy did could ever justify what happened to him.
You know, I read that in your book when she says that, and in one way it's the most obvious statement possible, yeah, right? Of course nothing that he did could justify what happened to him. But what importance do you feel, if any, of her finally saying it?
I'm sure it is important to the Till family and to other people who have, you know, have that kind of connection to the case. But, I certainly never thought she was telling the truth at trial. People are really interested because it's a mystery. She's been, you know, in hiding almost for all the 60-some years. It was her husband who did the killing and her brother-in-law. It's not clear what role she had in that, but the FBI investigated this in 2005 and said there was nothing to prosecute her on. And a grand jury that had a black majority ruled that not to indict her.
Do you know why she finally spoke?
I can't say for a fact. I can't read her mind, and she didn't say. There was kind of an implication that she was in poor health and getting on in years and wanted to have her say. And tell what she knew.
The real heroine of that, of the whole episode, is Emmett Till's mother, Mamie.
Yeah, so courageous. She brings Emmett's body back from Mississippi and has an open casket funeral so everybody can see what the world did to my boy, she said. She also gets on the phone even before the body comes back and starts calling reporters and just becomes a clearinghouse for this media operation.
It's fascinating because she took her personal grief and made it into a kind of public awareness.
Yes, that's right. And she knows Chicago, and she leverages the strength of Black Chicago, of the institutions that had been built there over the decades. You know, the Chicago Defender, the Johnson Publishing, which is Ebony and Jet, Black labor unions, and so on. With that, a movement emerges that becomes the infrastructure for a national civil rights movement. One of the grassroots activists in Mississippi spoke at Dexter Street Baptist Church, invited there by an unknown pastor named Martin Luther King. And Rosa Parks was in the congregation. And 4 days later, she was asked to move to the back of the bus. Mm. She later says, I thought about Emmett Till, and I could not move.
And the name Emmett Till, cited to this day.
He's emblematic of racial injustice in America and of violence against young Black men in particular, and the ruthless indifference to the lives of young Black men. So, this is a story that won't let us go.
What compels you? I mean, what pushes you personally to look at this history?
The summer that I turned 11, a boy that I played with every day, his father and his brothers, murdered this young Black man in public for speaking perhaps something flirtatious to a white woman at the store counter, and they chased him out of the store and shot him from behind and then beat his head in with the stocks of the rifles. And this was not a murder mystery. And they were acquitted really in protest against school integration. It was almost an atmosphere of war. And I wondered, how did this all get started? Why am I in this craziness? And that began a process of discovery that led me, you know, a long way.
The book is The Blood of Emmett Till. Timothy Tyson, thank you very much.
Thank you, Jeffrey. Thanks for having me.